The streets of Jerusalem echoed in song and with shouts of Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. For the followers of Jesus, this was truly a day of celebration as their king triumphantly rode into town on a donkey's colt, accompanied by jubilant praise. Hiding in the shadows of those same streets, however, skeptics and ruthless religious leaders gathered, sowing seeds of hate and doubt as they plotted to bring an end to this humble teacher's influence.
Surely these evil schemers could find an ally among those closest to the so-called Messiah. After all, anyone can be bought if the payment is adequate. And so the plan was hatched, a plan that would ultimately mean securing the aid of a willing disciple, one who would betray Jesus for a few pieces of silver.
Save us. Jesus and his disciples had come to Jerusalem to celebrate the Jewish Passover. As they gathered to share the Passover meal, Jesus told them of difficult days yet to come. He told them of betrayal and that he would soon be leaving them. Then he took the bread, broke it, and gave it to them. "This is my body given for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
After the meal, Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane. The burden of grief was overwhelming as Jesus anticipated the events that were ahead, which were to come and to all of his followers would soon experience. He poured out his heart in anguish. "Abba, Father, if it is possible, take this cup from me. Yet, not my will, but yours be done."
Jesus,
The solitude of a remote garden was suddenly shattered when an angry mob led by Judas arrived, armed with swords and clubs. They seized Jesus, arresting him and taking him to Caiaphas, the high priest, and the teachers of the law. In a night marked by betrayal, false accusations, and a mock trial, Jesus was sentenced to a criminal's death, crucifixion on a cross. In one final act of love, Jesus offered no resistance as he was handed over to the very people he had come to save.
Jesus was led to Golgotha, where he was nailed to a cross between two criminals. As witnesses mocked him, a company of soldiers divided up his clothes in a final act of humiliation. Darkness came over the whole land as the sun stopped shining and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Calling out in a loud voice, Jesus said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And then he died on the cross.
Amen.
At dawn, on the first day of the week, some of the women went to the tomb where Jesus had been buried. An angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus.
He is not here, for he has risen just as he said.
Go quickly and tell his disciples that
Jesus has risen from the dead.